Okay, so obviously one of the fun downsides with a hut is, they tend to be dark at night. 'Cause guess what? There's no electricity here. Which is kind of what makes it cool. Gonna take the heater lamp off and do this. That's really, oops, shit. That is really bright. Yeah, that's really, really bright. So, it's like there's no power in the huts. I don't know if you guys can see me or not. So it is quite dark, and this is exactly why. So it's 4 o'clock in the. It's only 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Sunset's not for another 2 hours. The temperature is already dropping, which is why my pack was heavy. Is I've got warm clothes. There's a fireplace here. I don't know if I can be bothered lighting it. Although it does give me an excuse to play with the fire lighting stuff I've got with me. Although, God, if I had to actually use it, it would be absolute shit because it's actually now raining. And it's getting worse. I'm definitely not walking out now. Because, there'd be a. Because a fair bit of it is in forest, it's going to be too dark. I'd be on my headlamp the whole time, which is fine. It's a bloody good headlamp. But what I'm going to do is instead, I'm actually going to swap cameras. Let's change mounting points. So I'm going to set up my bed and I'll run you guys through it when I'm done. Okay, so most of my shit's just exploded everywhere at the moment. And I'm going to see if I can get some better lighting. Okay, so as I said just before, like the lighting is going to be a bit iffy. So because this is a hut, and with most huts in New Zealand, most of them have mattresses. However, I'm not going to use it. I'm going to try my bedroll. So I literally just bought this 2 days ago. And I'll probably time lapse the setup of it. I just actually want to see what it's like to actually sleep on. So I might as well set it up and use it. And I've got to get this set up and I've got to get my sleeping bag out just so it can inflate.
completely inflated. So, the camera's probably missed all of that, but it doesn't really matter. This is the exact reason why my pack was 17 kilos. Because I've tried to minimize the crap I bring. I bought a pillow. Honestly, if your head's comfortable, you'll get a good night's sleep. So, now, yeah, I can let that loft up and do its thing. It's been cooped up in that bag for quite a while, for a day. It is down, so it's going to need a chance to puff up or loft up, whatever the hell it is. I'm going to go have a cup of soup. Probably a miso, and it'll be me for a while. So I think I mentioned in a previous video, I bought a Gorilla Pod. So it's one of those weird bendy flexible tripods that's what I've been using, and there's a couple of photos of it. If you're ever in doubt, just buy one. Yeah, it's, so far it's been absolutely brilliant. I need my fuel bottle, so we're gonna go for a walk. So the legs are stiff enough, I can hold it by one leg like this, and just walk off. The pedaling fuel bottle. This is like enough fuel for 3 or 4 days, enough. So for an overnight, that's tons. I do have a big one. I don't need it. Choice for dinner tonight is backcountry cuisine, tequila gummy, pretty good, it's actually really good, Mexican chicken. Just read the back of the packet, it has nacho chips in it. Oops, this was stuffed in the bottom of my pack, I'm pretty sure I'm going to have nacho dust. The other thing, and I meant to grab them but I forgot, was my jandals, just to wear around the hut.
just take some of the impact out of walking on a hard floor in socks. So note for next time, don't forget the jandals and don't crush the nachos. Okay, so this will probably be my last vlog, just quickly. Or last entry for this bit. Other people are here. So yeah, should be interesting. Right, catch you guys later.